Hello friends, once again Sugesh here. I'm going to shoot a quick video for you on roles. What is roles in SAP? So basically a role is a set of transaction code assigned for a particular role name, and it's been used for any kind of users whom are being created in the system. So the definition for role should be set as a set of transaction code assigned for a user, or basically a set of transaction code assigned for a name of a particular role. Okay, and this roles can be used later at any stage instead of creating multiple transaction codes for authorization for individual users. So I'm just going to show you a simple and a quick video. How do we create an SAP role? I'm going to log in. Logged in. So here we go. I have been logged in, and the transaction code to create a role is PFCG. I say enter. Look at this. Any custom or user defined roles should start with Z. Otherwise, there are a lot of transaction, a lot of roles in the system which is other than Z. So general Z or Y, or I call we can start with Z or Z. So I may put in a role name which is Z ME basis. Okay, a basis. Okay, I'm going to put Z middleist basis users. Okay, so I say go straight away single role. I'm going to create a single role now. And what is a composite role? A role inside a role which is called as a composite role. So I'm going to click on single role. I say click. So you can see this menu here. In this menu, I will say save now. The moment I say save now, it's asking for this particular ZME basis users. What are the transaction codes to be assigned? That means whatever the transaction code you assign for this particular role name, okay, will be saved for this particular role name, and this role name can be used for any other users. That means whomever the user you assign this particular role, those users will be only able to access the transaction code what you've been assigning here. So for example, imagine that this user will use only a transaction code SF01, which is to create a user. Enter. Maybe I'll give him SM01. Okay, lock transactions, and I'll give him SM02. Okay, these are a few modern basis transaction codes, and I will also give him SM51. Okay. List of the system, SAP system, and SM52. Okay, now I say assign this. Okay, now you can see the red menu has been red signal over here. Okay, so I say assign this. It takes generally takes role creation few seconds extra. Okay, so it's just assigning this particular T code to this particular role name. So maybe just bear me a second. Now you can see it has been assigned perfectly, successfully, and you can always see the menu has been changed. Now I'm going to restrict authorizations here. Okay, if I wanted to change and again do a second level of entries restrictions in it, I can always do it. So I say just save this now. You can always see the authorization is always there. It has a red signal now. Maybe bear me a minute. It's just getting saved. Yeah, it's getting saved. Yeah, now you can see I'm going to give the full authorization. I don't want to restrict anything in between. If I wanted to restrict anything, I can all been manually done without executing. I can just generating. I can leave as it is. Otherwise, I just give the complete object authorization. Okay, so it all comes to the green. So I given for this transaction of the full authorization. Okay, for the, all these things. Now I say just generate. I said okay. So it's just getting saved over here. Yeah, good, fantastic. So that is done. Now I will go back again. I'll go back again here. Okay. Then now menu part is done. Authorization part is done. Okay. Now only one part is filled. Even if you wanted to give a description over here, you can give it. Whatever description you are for your understanding. Now the user part is not assigned. Now this is ready. This user is ready. So this role is ready. It can be assigned for any user. Even you can directly assign it from here, or you can even remove from it. Now I'll go to assign one user here, Yami Dubai 01. I'll put it. Okay, I just click on compare user. So I say complete compare. Said yes. What happens is complete transaction code assigned over here will be compared and updated for this particular user, and this user will be able to do the complete execution of this transaction code, whatever it is, whatever the list of transaction code assigned in it. So here you go, it gets saved in a second. Simple. So now you can see almost everything has come in the green color. That means everything is done. Then I just save it. Okay, so I just log out of this. Okay, then I'm going to log in again to the system. Okay, then I'm putting in the user, menu Dubai 01. The password is microepsil. So here you see the list of transaction code assigned for this particular user is limited now. So he is able to do only these transaction codes. Okay, so this is a simple and short quick video for you on role creation. Thank you very much.